that maybe don't. I'm Shelley Fordyce, Director of Student Activities. Myself, and then we have Taylor Kemp, and we have Derek Ford. The three of us make up student activities and work very closely with all the student organizations and student organization officers, especially, that you all work with. So first off, thank you all for agreeing to be advisors. I know it's an added piece on your plate. Some of you are advisors of multiple organizations, and so extra kudos to you. We know they are amazing, and they make our lives very very happy, but they're needy too, so we get that. So thank you very much. You do make a huge impact on those students. I know Dr. Lashar mentions this a lot, that they did a former student survey not too long ago, and something that just kept coming back with former students that made their experience at AM so so memorable and so beneficial to them was their involvement in student organizations. And you guys played a huge role in that, so thank you very much. So kind of what we have planned, I'm going to talk a little bit about kind of your role as an advisor and kind of what you should be thinking of as you're advising different student groups. We're going to kind of bring up and kind of go through fairly quickly some of the training that they have been through, because I think it's helpful for you guys to at least know what they've already heard so that you can kind of help advise them in those things as well. Because sometimes I don't know how much they're listening. So if we have another set of ears that maybe hears what they're supposed to be doing, it should be helpful. Okay, so just kind of a little bit of a role, your role as an advisor. A lot of times the advisor, for a lot of you, it's going to be working really closely with the officers. Sometimes they have their meetings at 10 o'clock at night, and there's not always an expectation that you're going to be at all those meetings when they're that kind of crazy schedule. But you want to get familiar with their guiding documents. So if you have not seen your organization's constitution, let us know and we can get you a copy of it. Sometimes we'll have, they have to be renewed every 2 years, so especially if you're a fairly new advisor to the group, you may not have seen the most recent one because it may have been from the previous advisor that had signed off on it. So just let us know and we can get you a copy to look at. If you become aware of any discipline issues or things that you think your club is doing that are not on board with university rules, that's your responsibility to report those things to us so we can look into it. And you just really need to be aware of what those rules are. University student rules are on our homepage. There's a link. So, but I think most of you are probably pretty familiar. Being aware of liability issues and work with the organization to make reasonable and prudent decisions regarding these issues. When you go through, one of the things that you'll do as an advisor is looking through their event forms. When they are going to have an event, they have to submit an event form just to let us know what they're planning. And going, just like reading through what they see as the risks, like what are their activities, what do they see as risks, and how do they plan to mitigate those risks? You as an advisor looking through that is like a huge step forward, because if you start asking those questions, we also ask those questions, but it's important that you as an advisor, because you're going to be asked to give your okay on those events, so it's really important that you start thinking about those things as well. Attend meetings when possible, but that is completely up to you and your officers to talk about whether that's an expectation. It is not an expectation from our office that you go to all of their meetings, but sometimes you will have, especially young officers of a group, that they do really want an advisor there. And so at that point, you kind of have to come to a good compromise as to what's a reasonable time for meeting for you to actually be there. And really just being available to the officers for advice and consulting, so that they probably will come to you. I know a lot of times they come to you with people issues within the club, or they may have financial things. Certainly, our office is here to answer those questions with you, to help you guys answer those questions as well. So please don't feel like you're all alone out there to answer those things. So some of the things when you're trying to decide how much advising your group really needs, you're going to have groups that are at many different levels as you go through. And you may have a group at one level 1 year, and then the next year, some of them graduate, and you're starting all over again. So it's really important to kind of think about different factors that play into that. First thing is, I mentioned development level of the group. You know, are you working with sophomores that kind of got thrown in as officers because all the seniors graduated the year before? Or do you have people that they're, you know, a pretty high functioning team and they've been working, you know, together for a long time? But thinking about the university's expectations of this group, you know, are they in maroon coats and they're going out and they're maroon delegates and they're out representing the university to high power people in the community? You know, if they're a group that's really just very recreational and they don't have a high impact necessarily on the university as a whole, obviously student life, they all have a function there. Is it a specific program or activity? So like SALT Camp, their job is to put on a university program, activity for incoming students. Does the university pay for things? That also adds into how critical your advising role is. You know, if the university is giving them money to do a function of the university, then that you have to be real careful about what, you know, that the university is going to have higher expectations. The students that had expectations, I talked about this a little bit earlier. You know, you really just need to sit down and talk with your officers and find out, you know, what do you want my role to be? How involved do you want me to be? Do you want me at every meeting? Do you care if I come to any meetings? A lot of times we say, we would love for you to come to meetings, but we understand that you may not be able to, and we're fine without, you know, without you. And usually when I have groups that say that, I say, okay, but I'd like to meet with you, the officers, once a month at least. You know, come, or every other week, come check in with me and let me know what's going on, just so they, that, you know, I'm still involved with that. And then your advising style. So you have to kind of think about what is appropriate for you. Where are you comfortable with as an advisor? So when you look at the level of your group, you've got infancy. So these are, I'm going to go through these fairly quickly, but they have poor program planning skills, a low level of commitment. So they may not have been involved with the organization very long. They may have just kind of got thrown in the year before. And kind of a lack of responsibility for their actions. In the adolescent phase, they kind of have basic programming skills. They understand what they're supposed to be doing. They are fairly committed to the organization and some degree of responsibility. Then you go to young adulthood, and they're competent in putting on a program. There's a high level of commitment, and they are fully responsible for their actions. And then at maturity, these are kind of our advanced groups. And a lot of times I feel like I use SALT Camp a lot as my example, but when my students, when they get up to that level of being directors, especially in that month or two right before camp, I feel like they're at maturity. Like, they take full responsibility for everything. They're the ones that are going out and planning every part of camp. They implement, they go out and evaluate what they're doing, they know what's working and what's not. They do a lot of group decision making. So they have kind of a really, really strong commitment to their goals of the organization. It really, they take it very personally. If something's not going right, you know, it's hard on them. And they, you know, they take responsibility for what goes well. So you have your four different advising styles. So you can be a program director, program teacher, program advisor, or a program consultant. So if you're as a program director, you're going to be working directly with the students to get things done. So you're really focused on the product and say, okay, you say you want to have this event. Let's sit down and what are we going to do step by step? How are we going to get that done? If you're a program teacher, you're still focused on getting that thing done, but you turn some of the little basic responsibilities, like, okay, so you need to go to this person and you're going to go reserve this room. And so you may be helping to kind of dole out responsibilities So you're still kind of, you're kind of in there, you're teaching them, okay, these are the things that need to get done, somebody go and do it, but you're not the one, you're not hand-holding them to go get it done. So you're also starting to think about how they're doing it, who is doing these things, and what is being accomplished. When you go into that advisor role, you're going to start thinking a lot more in the process. And so you're going to be helping them come up with like group decision-making skills and how the group is working together. Are they evaluating what they're doing? So it's a lot more process-based. And the consultant, you're available. You can advise, or you can provide any historical context. Well, this is how it's been taken care of in the past. I know that you can talk to this person on campus as a resource. You can, I know. Well, here's where the university rules are. And let's see if if there's a way to work around the situation so you're not breaking rules. But you're not necessarily. You're not there at every meeting. You're not making sure X, Y, and Z is getting done. You're kind of in your office and they come to consult with you as needed. So you can see this can fall into kind of a four quadrants. So in quadrant one, you have the advisor is kind of, or the university has an expectation for a product to be, a program to be put out there. So in the students, maybe an infant